Hello, Stacker. SoCal Freelance here. Just want to give you an end of the year stack update. And this is the year in terms of spot price. So I've made several purchases over the year. And my last big purchase was here in June. And then I pretty much stopped spending until November here when the spot price was back in the 16s. So I did make some purchases when the spot price is really high, and what I've purchased when it's high like this are usually things that are already high in terms of price, and it doesn't matter what the spot price is. These things will always be high, like proof coins like these from Russia, or things that don't follow spot price, such as various silver certificates and other types of things of this nature. So let's go over some of the things I did purchase since my last stack update. I purchased some 2016 ASEs, proof ASEs. And then I have various other proof coins here from various countries. I thought this one was cool. It's a woodland gnome type of thing. I think this is Kazakhstan. Let's see here. I'm not sure. I don't recall. Royal Canadian Mint proof coins, adding to my half ounce collection. And then here's a Lotus coin, Year of the Rooster for 2016. Other coins. St. George the Victorious coins from Russia, two sheets of those. My first Chinese coin, and this is the Moon Festival coin, the 2 ounce version. It's a great coin. So, what a way to start a Chinese collection. Start with one of the best you can get. This is a PF70. Purchased some 1 ounce bars, Scottsdale, and I'm debating whether to break open this pack or not. It's kind of difficult to store something like this. This is a limited edition 1 ounce bar here, and then here's a more generic Scottsdale bar. Security feature in the back there. And yes, I purchased some Trump coins, or not rounds. It's weird, I don't usually purchase rounds, but I did this for the history of the event. And the guy that purchased these, he was making these well before Trump was making a name for himself in politics. And I learned about this through the Coin Week YouTube channel, and I really like that channel because it has some great speakers, has some great information. I really recommend it to people. Visit that site, and if you have a 4K monitor, they do a lot of their videos in 4K, which is even nicer. Queen's Beast. So, you know, I purchased the 1 ouncer gold, and then here's the quarter ounce gold. So 4 quarter ounce lion beasts, and then as well as the silver, 2 ounce silver as well. So keeping up with that series. And then for Christmas, I got two Royal Mint coins, the 90th birthday coin, and then Shakespeare coin. That was a very nice Christmas present. And then ASEAN coin, which is somewhat limited edition, very rare. And this will go well with my my BRICS coin. And then here are some 5 ounce proof, Russian proof. You can see the intricate detail of the laser detail there. really quite an amazing coin. Mirror finish. Same thing with this one. Okay. Another 1 ounce bar here. And I have 2 unboxings, so let's do that. Okay, we have our first unboxing here. Okay, Queen's Beast Griffin coins. Got a tube of them. So keeping up with the Queen's Beast series in earnest. And here is the next unboxing. Okay, we've got 5 2017 Kookaburras. Ounce year of the rooster. Two more RCM 10 ounce bars for my collection. Some Noah's Ark coins. Armenia Noah Ark coins. I have 5 of those. And then we've got some Asahi 1 ounce bars here. We've got 10 of those. And 10 Silvertown bars. And the last one here. Royal Canadian Mint Bink Coin Series. Let's see what number I got here. $13.63 out of $21.50 made. And this is a 5 ounce proof coin. Very well made. So for the second half of 2016, I have roughly 148 ounces of silver and 1 ounce of gold to add to the stack. I wish you all the best for 2017 and keep on stacking.